It feels weird to recommend this one, given that originally this was a game made for mobile phones, which has now been ported over to Steam. It's weird because typically mobile phone games are light on depth and quality and weighed down by frequent adverts and prompts for in-app purchases. But Exception isn't one of those games, at least not anymore. Exception exists in the mysterious and unloved world of premium mobile games. From my own experience and talks I've listened to from mobile developers at GDC, no one really cares for premium mobile games. I thought about it and the only two I own are Mini Metro and Monument Valley. Mini Metro I bought having already enjoyed the game on PC when it was on sale for 99 pence, and Monument Valley I got for free. Looking at a few lists of top premium mobile games, for the most part these titles are ports from other platforms, games like Stardew Valley, Minecraft, Football Manager, and the entire PlayStation 2 Grand Theft Auto trilogy. So it's not unusual to see non-mobile games have successful mobile ports, but it is unusual to see mobile games have successful non-mobile ports. And because it's so unusual, I suppose you could say that this makes Exception a bit of an outlier. Exception, this one, not this one, is a puzzle game where you program a bunch of malfunctioning robots called Exceptions across a set of 30 increasingly challenging levels to tag objectives, destroy generators, and kill enemy robots. It calls itself a programming game, but programming is a bit of a stretch. Exception is a puzzle game, but one that does feature ideas from programming, namely loops, conditional statements, and booleans. I am going to say program and code to describe the gameplay because thematically that's correct, but whenever you hear those words, just imagine that I'm also doing air quotes. The code, or list of instructions that you write, consists of a series of lines all reading when this, do this, and the lower a line is, the higher its priority if multiple conditions are triggered. The basic set of instructions you can give the exceptions are moving, either to a waypoint or retreating from an enemy, firing the exceptions' weapons, or activating one of 9 signals that can be used to communicate between your robots. As for the conditions, you can set these instructions to occur based on an exception's proximity to a waypoint, whether it can detect an enemy, and whether it can detect a particular signal from an ally. For example, exception A could turn on signal 1 after reaching a waypoint, and in turn this tells exception B to start moving. There are other instructions and conditions, but the ones I mentioned are the ones you use all the time. Solving puzzles usually starts off quite sensibly, with a basic idea of what you want to happen. So you put in a few instructions, hit the play button, and watch your units inevitably fail. But you get some new ideas about what you're doing wrong. With every attempt, you learn a little bit more about how this particular level plays out, helping you to incrementally build a more comprehensive list of instructions to complete it. This does mean that Exception involves a certain amount of trial and error, which might not sound appealing to you, but this also has an upside. Because the best approach to solving levels is fundamentally trial and error, constantly iterating on an idea and making frequent changes based on what you see failing in front of you, it means that you're always doing something. There are very few robotic moments between solving the puzzle theoretically and solving the puzzle in the game. You're always, attempt after attempt, pushing slightly closer towards the solve. This, to me, is the best approach to puzzle design in a video game. Video games are supposed to be interactable, that's what they offer over other mediums, so puzzle games should, at least in part, need you to solve by doing. The puzzles in Exception are a lot of fun to solve, and there's great variety in the approaches you have to take to solving them, and the 30 levels Exception offers have about 5 to 10 hours of gameplay. Visually, Exception is clean and simple, all the information you need is easy to pick out, and the animations are nice enough that the robots carrying out your code is really satisfying to watch. Ask anyone who's played Factorio, there's a lot of fun to be had from just watching an automated system that you built. Every level starts with a brief summary from a mystery agent about what to expect in the level, but this is also where the game throws in some light details about the evil corporation you're fighting against. It's not much of a story, per se, but this little bit of added context helps the levels from feeling completely arbitrary. The background music for the game isn't bad, and it's definitely thematic of a futuristic space-age lab. The sound effects, on the other hand, you'll want to turn way down in the volume. If you don't, the music in every single level will get drowned out by the repetitive sound of cheap laser gunfire effects. Oh, thank God it's over. The one thing I think Exception could really have benefited from is some slightly more open-ended levels and an optimization system like the iconic histograms of Zachtronics titles like Space Chem. Space Chem is a similar game in many ways to Exception. They're both puzzle games about automation and programming. But one of the features that makes Space Chem so replayable is that when you finish a level, it plots your solution on three histograms and teases you with the knowledge that there's a better way to solve this level. One that's much faster or one that's more efficient. Because the game demonstrates that there is a better solution to find and shows you that there will be a reward for your effort, even if that reward is just a better position on the histogram, it gives you an incentive to go back and replay levels. When I completed a level in Exception, I was just sort of done with it. A few times, more often than not to be honest, I looked at my code and thought that could probably be done much better. But I wasn't going to do anything about it because I didn't have the confidence that there was a much better solution to find, and I didn't feel like there would be enough reward for trying. The only time I did go and spend time replaying a level was because a Steam achievement told me that a level could be completed in less than 30 seconds, demonstrating, like Space Chem's histograms, that there was an optimal solution out there if you put in the time. And so I did, because I enjoy the game. Unfortunately, the solution looks like this, and there's no way any rational human being would ever get to it. I'm not going to explain why I think this achievement is almost rude to put in the game, but if you're interested, ask me in the comments. Space Chem's efficiency and speed challenges are a huge part of why that game has longevity and depth. It also shifts Space Chem from being a puzzle-solving game to being a problem-solving game. Sounds like the same thing, but the key difference between the two is that puzzle games are about finding a specific solution, while problem solvers are about solving a specific problem. That sounds like the same thing again. Okay, puzzles can be solved in one way. Problems have a range of solutions. And honestly, if a game has a set of mechanics that could create a puzzle solver or a problem solver, like Exception, like Space Chem, like At a Stretch, Factorio, I can't think of many situations where it wouldn't be an improvement to have that range of possibilities and freedom for creativity that problem-solving games can offer. Because if you just want to one and done the levels of a problem-solving game, then it contains an identical puzzle game within it anyway. Exception isn't as good a game as Space Chem. They share a lot of similarities, but Space Chem does a few things a little bit better. But that doesn't make Exception a bad game at all. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and if the idea of logically iterating on a plan to automate some robots sounds like your idea of a fun evening, then, well, here's my conclusion. I definitely recommend Exception. But if you haven't played Space Chem, play that first. Links to both games in the description. If you're jonesing for a puzzle game, but Exception and Space Chem don't quite sound like your thing, then maybe check out Perspective, a fantastic puzzle game with the added bonus of being completely free. Or if you're looking for more great indie titles to look forward to, then here's a breakdown of some of the top indie games announced at E3 this year. Thank you for watching, and if you're subscribed to the channel, I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.